Hi students, today our topic is consideration of current in different cases. Okay, that means cause of current. Okay, see in metallic wire cause of current is electrons. Cause of current is, that means current is developed by electrons. Okay, because of in metals or in conductors. Okay, number of free electrons are there. These electrons are called valency electrons. Okay, already we discussed drift velocity. Okay, drift velocity order 10 to the power of minus 4 meter per second. Okay, you know already drift velocity concept in metallic wire. So drift velocity of electrons is 10 to the power of minus 4 meter per second. Okay, in semiconductors here current is constituted with electrons and also holes. Understood? So in semiconductors, current is constituted with the help of electrons and also holes. Okay, next, current in gases. Okay, actually gases are insulators to electricity. Okay, these are insulators, but gases are ionized at a very high potential and at low pressure. So on that case consider the current in that one due to positive ions, due to electrons. Okay, here gas is placed in a discharge tube. It is also explained in atoms. Okay, so current in metallic wire due to electrons, semiconductors due to electrons and holes, in gases at a high potential and low pressure. So positive ions and electron. Understood? Okay, electrolyte due to positive ions and negative ions in electrolyte. Here consider the current due to positive ions, at the same time negative ions. Understood? Okay, positive ions and negative ions. So next, most important one, relation between current and drift velocity. Okay, first of all, consider one conductor. Okay, consider one conductor. Its length is L, cross sectional area is A. Okay, now consider one conductor. So L is the length of the conductor. Understood? First of all, consider one conductor. Its length is L. A. What is A here? Cross sectional area. Cross sectional area of the conductor. Understood? Okay, now volume of this conductor. Volume means area into length here. Okay, volume of the conductor is equal to area into length. Understood? Okay, now here small n is the number of electrons per unit volume. Understood? Okay. Here small n, consider first of all, small n is the number of electrons per unit volume. If in case you consider one unit volume, in that number of electrons are n. Okay, but here we consider l length of conductor, its area is a, that means it having some volume v. Understood? Okay, so that means it having number of electrons, it having number of electrons, that means n is total number of electrons in that conductor. N is the total number of electrons. How to find out total number of electrons? Okay, how to find out total number of electrons? See, one unit volume, how many electrons are there? N. Okay, small n is nothing but here number of electrons per unit volume. That means in one unit volume, number of electrons are n. But here volume is AL. That means in AL units, how many electrons are there? How many electrons are there? How to find out that one? See, like one pen cost 5 rupees. Okay. 10 pence cost? 10 pence cost how much? 5 into 10. That means 50 rupees. Like that one? In one unit volume, number of electrons are. In AL unit volume, number of electrons are, you write as N into AL. N into AL. Understood? Okay. Now, total number of electrons are N is equal to AL into small n. AL into small n. These are the number of electrons. Okay. Now, total charge. Total charge. How to find out the total charge? Total number of electrons are N. Each of charge is E. So total number of electrons are N and charge is E. So total charge is equal to here A L N into E. A L N into E. Understood? Once again, small l, length of the conductor, A, cross-sectional area of the conductor. Volume of the conductor is equal to area into length. You know that one. Small n is nothing but number of electrons per unit volume. Capital N is the total number of electrons. Okay. So total charge is equal to what I do here? AL N into E. Okay. AL N into E. Understood? Okay. Now, some constant potential difference is applied to this conductor. Constant potential difference is applied to this conductor. Okay. Battery positive terminal, negative terminal. Some constant potential difference is developed. Its length is L. Its cross-sectional area A. Now, developed electric field is this one. In that conductor, developed electric field is from positive to negative. From positive to negative. Understood? Now, electrons moves opposite to the electric field with average velocity. With the average velocity. Average velocity means drift velocity. Average velocity means drift velocity. Are you understood? Average velocity means here drift velocity. Okay. So these are moving with drift velocity. Okay. Here electric field is right as potential difference by length. Okay. Potential difference by length. Understood? Okay.
So once note this one, L length of the conductor, A cross sectional area, volume of the conductor AL, small n is the number of electrons per unit volume, capital N total number of electrons in that conductor, total charge AL n into E. Okay.
Now electrons, okay, now electrons travels from this end to this end with a drift velocity. Okay, these are takes certain time. Okay, time taken to cross the electrons this conductor length L. Okay, time taken to cross the electrons this length L, time is equal to, you write as length by drift velocity. Okay, time is equal here length by drift velocity. Okay, here developed current is, in this case developed current is current I is equal to, you write as charge by time. Charge means total charge. Charge means total charge. You know charge, what are the one, A L N E. Okay, A L N E is the total charge. Time L by V suffix D. Substituting here, I is equal to Q A L N E. Time is L by V suffix D. Now here L L cancel. V suffix D is taken upon. I is equal to N E A V suffix D. Are understood? I is equal to N E A V suffix D. It is the relation between current and drift velocity. Simply drift velocity is write as drift velocity is equal to I by N E. Drift velocity is equal to, I means current, N means number of electrons per unit volume, E means charge of electron, A means cross sectional area. You know drift velocity is, you know already drift velocity is equal to, drift velocity is equal to E by M into tau. You know this one already. Okay, substituting here N E A in vector notation, negative is required. In magnitude we consider, so negative indicates electrons are moving in opposite direction of the electric field. Okay, generally drift velocity taken in negative, cause of negative is, so electrons are moves opposite to the electric field. Okay, N E A V sub X D by M into tau, E into E, N E square A E by M into tau. N E square A E by M into tau in terms of electric field. Okay, it is the relation between drift velocity and current. Okay, relation between drift velocity and current. Same, drift velocity directly proportional to electric field. That means electric field intensity is increases, what about drift velocity? It is also increases. It is also increases. Okay, drift velocity depends on area. Drift velocity is also depends on area. Okay, now in terms of current density, in terms of current density, current per unit area, what are one? Current density. So drift velocity is equal to J by N E. So current density is equal to N E into V D. Understood? So drift velocity, you know this formula already. Okay, in terms of current. Okay, so another form of this one, simply to write as I is equal to n e square a e by m into tau. Okay, and in terms of current density, n e into v d. In terms of current density, n e into v d. Understood? Okay. Now you consider non-uniform cross-sectional area. Okay, that means area changes. Like here, it is one of the conductor. What about its area changes? Area is changes. Understood? In this case, which quantities are constant? Which quantities are changes? Here constant quantities are charge and current, because of these two are independent on area. These two are independent on area. Understood? Variable quantities current density, okay, drift velocity and electrical intensity. Okay, here mainly constant one is charge and current. Variable quantities are current density and drift velocity. Okay, mainly these are variable. Okay, see next one, mobility. Okay, so here drift velocity, cause of drift velocity due to external electric field. Okay, if in case you are applying the electric field intensity E, drift velocity is v sub x d. One unit of electric field intensity, what about drift velocity here? V sub x d by E. Okay, you consider only magnitude. Okay, understood? The average drift velocity resulting from the application of unit electric field strength. Okay, that means drift velocity per unit electric field strength is nothing but mobility. Okay, mobility is nothing but drift velocity per unit electric field strength. Per unit electric field strength. Understood? Okay, now it is always positive. Either positive charges or negative charges, it is always positive. Okay, mobility is always positive. Units here, units, velocity meter per second. Okay, electric field intensity newton per coulomb. Understood? So units are meter coulomb, second newton, simply meter second inverse of, okay, coulomb newton inverse. Dimensional formula for this one, meter L second T coulomb AT and newton MLT power of minus 2. Okay, here L cancel, T cancel, M power of minus 1 T square A. Okay, M power of minus 1 T square A is the dimensional formula of mobility. Mobility is simply drift velocity per unit electric field intensity. It is always positive. Okay, see one problem. Consider a wire of length 4 meter and cross-sectional area 1 millimeter square. Okay, here length is 4 meter, cross-sectional area 1 millimeter square, current carrying a current of 2 ampere. If each cubic meter of the material contains 10 to the power of 29 free electrons, find the average time taken by an electron to cross the length of the wire. See, here given data, length of the wire is 4 meter. Okay, cross sectional area 1 millimeter square means 10 to the power of minus 6 meter square. Okay, current. What is the current here? 2 ampere. Okay, number of electrons per unit volume is 10 to the power of 29. What is the required quantity here? T. So time, you know formula, T is equal to L by V sub x d. V sub x d is equal to I by NEA. I by NEA. Substituting here, L by I by NEA. So L N E A by I. Okay, that means time is equal to L. L means 4. N means 10 to the power of 29. E means charge of electron 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. What about area? 10 to the power of minus 6 by 2. 2 to 0. 2 into 1.6. 3.2. 2 into 1.6, 3.2. 10 to the power of 29, 10 to the power of minus 19, 10 to the power of plus 10, plus 10 minus 6, 4, 10 to the power of 4 seconds. Understood? T is equal to 3.2 into 10 to the power of 4 seconds. T is equal to length by drift velocity. Simply L NEA by I. Understood? Okay.